in August of 2003. Our leaders felt like the Lord had asked us to raise $20 million for four things, one of which was to launch Harvest Christian Academy. It was really an idea. It was going to be one of the greatest discipleship ministries of our church to disciple the next generation for Christ.
I remember sitting in a church service where it was said, okay, we are going to start taking applications for teaching. And so I applied and I was the first hire, according to the principal. She said, congratulations, you are the first hire of Harvest Christian Academy.
I remember walking around and Julie Giardino saying, well, here's going to be classrooms and this is going to be this and this is going to be this. And it was all just green carpet everywhere. And then we're all looking for teachers and people kept coming along on the team.
I had to wear a hard hat at my interview as they took me around the campus, and they were still saying things 2 weeks before school, like, here's where the cafeteria is going to be. And I kept looking out over a sea of cubicles thinking, I don't know how this is going to be a school in 2 weeks.
We literally had to rely on the Lord for every next step. I can't tell you how we just prayed for enrollment, just for kids to show up and for families to come.
We decided to get on board and send our daughter to an idea that was being created here. We were able to walk through these hallways, and there was stud walls up in a few places, and the vision was here. We got on board to that vision and decided this is where she's going to be.
The first year of school, it was a startup for a school. It was small. We were down in I don't think we're even legally allowed to call it a gym. It was the activity space downstairs. We had every classroom that met there, and there was one class on half the gym and the other class on the other half of the gym.
I just remember loving it. It was always a youth group and Awana, and so that felt very similar to me, and I never had that in a school setting. I remember having my Bible was like part of the school supplies. That was so new to me. We just did so many things that you don't do in a public school.
I started in kindergarten and just went all the way through senior year of high school. As a result of that, you kind of just felt this strong community. Everybody knew each other. You'd see each other outside of school, and it didn't feel weird because you felt like you were a part of that. My most fun memories were camaraderie with my teammates on the cross country team and in the track team. It's hard to say where I wasn't benefited, where I wasn't growing, where I wasn't, you know, improving in some way, whether it's academically, in my faith, or in my personal skills with others.
Just really fun to like think back on all the memories I made, being like our friendships as like we kind of grew up. I think that's what made it really special.
We've done alumni surveys, and the biggest common theme that we've seen is, what did you love most about HCA? Was my friendships, my teachers.
Coaching is my platform. Coaching is a platform for discipleship and building relationships with kids. We do want to be great athletes, and we want to put together great teams. But that is nothing if we're not great followers of Christ.
I would say HCA is a family. We get to see the kids inside of the classroom for 50 minutes, but we get to see them outside of school in athletics. We get to see them at church on the weekends. It's a community of people that are like-minded to advance the gospel of Christ.
We had some difficulties as a family. We lost their dad to cancer, and the school family just really surrounded us and helped us, helped me support the kids in that difficult time.
I'm glad we were part of that growing process with the school. Mm-hmm. I mean, we had challenges to walk through, but yet it's what made the process, I think, really rewarding.
Every time things seem hard or rough, it's like, okay, here's what the Lord did again, and just time and time again, to see what he has brought the school through. Little bumps, big bumps, but just his faithfulness in the school has totally grown.
I've seen so much progress and growth and amazing things in the programs. Two of our kids have graduated from HCA, and it's been great to be able to kind of send them off and move them on to their next stages with such a solid foundation.
After seeing what the school has done through our kids, I would love to see more kids being able to go through the same thing. The impact that it has on them is unreal.
To see where it is now, yeah, from 20 years ago when it started, it's amazing. And we are so thankful for the school, and amazing to see what God has done.
We have a very strong foundation with a biblical worldview, a strong academic program, and those two blending together and partnering with our parents, we have a great opportunity to make our school whatever we want it to be.
For the next 20 years of Harvest, it's just exciting to see how it's going to grow.
I don't know what the Lord has for us, but I've already seen how he's grown the school and how he's expanded our high school. I'm excited to see more people come and experience what we have at HCA.
Equipping the next generation is one of the most important things that we can do. And that's one of the best things about Harvest is no matter all the stuff that's gone on throughout the years, the ups and downs, right? It's always back to the mission of seeing students being trained up as followers, as disciples.
Lives have been changed because of being on staff or sending their children or being part of the community here. Who knows what the Lord has in store for the next 20 years.